Hi there, it's Sandy Alnock, and today I've got two fabulous drawings for you. Aren't these beautiful? Can you see them? It's time to try using more useless art supplies, because there are some that I don't really find a use for. I've got two different papers, and I'm going to use some of this black light ink because I found it fascinating and I thought I'd try it. And I'm going to use my glass pens with it. Glass pens are really inexpensive. They're dip pens as opposed to pens with cartridges in them. And I needed a black light. So I found this tiny black light flashlight. I don't know what I'm going to use that for either. I hear you can find cat pee with it if that's what you're looking for. But I bought it for this project because I wanted to see how this would work. So I have dipped my pen into the black light ink and I'm drawing on the white paper. I tried a bunch of other papers and the ink tended to bleed a little bit, got a little bit fuzzy on softer papers. So I went for the Canson XL because it's got a little tougher surface and held up better to the ink. So I tried a whole bunch of different ones and this is what I found worked best, and started drawing a river with fish in it because with everything going on in the world right now, if you're watching this in the time frame in which it actually went live, you'll know that we have been looking for justice. And I kept thinking about the verse from scripture that talks about justice flowing like a river. So I had rivers on my mind, so I've got some fish swimming down a river in my doodle. The other drawing on the black paper, I was trying to think of an animal that was something I could draw on black, and since the ink is light, then how is that going to play out on black? And I realized I would have to draw something where the ink would be the light parts. And what would be a black animal that I could draw? And a black panther was one of the first ones that came to mind. And so I drew that. I did give myself a couple of dots of reference. You can see little dots for the nose down there. And I put dots in the corners of the eyes because I'm not that good. I can't just totally make this up and make the line drawing come out evenly and that sort of thing. So I did give myself a little bit of cheaters, but just started working through making the fur and the eyes and all the features of the cat. One of the things I found out after I'd finished the drawing, which was a little surprised but kind of seemed to make sense, is that a panther, when you talk about characteristics that animals represent, one of the characteristics of a panther is justice that it represents. I have no idea how or why anyone would come up with that, but it also makes sense with the black panthers, like why they would have chosen that animal back in the 60s when they were fighting for justice. So there's that, regardless of whether you like or dislike what that means. That was just a little tidbit that I found out about panthers as I was doing after I was finished with this drawing. So with this ink on black paper, one of the things that you need to think about is that it's going to dry back to that sort of purpley color. You can tell which parts are still wet because they're more that brighter green color, and it all dulls out a little bit down to that purplish once it's completely dry. So you can even see that the nib of the pen is much greener than everything else because that's the one that's been dipped into the fresh ink. And every time I make fresh marks on it, it tends to be brighter. So watch your hand if you use this ink. Don't lean in anything because you can't really see what you're doing. But when you are finished, you may find that you have glow-in-the-dark fingers. I had a little bit of that going on myself. So there's that. But it was fun to play around with this ink. My problem is I don't know how useful it is, because if you were to do a finished art piece and hang it up on the wall, you'd have to have a black light shining on it all the time. If you used it on a card, the person receiving the card would have to have a black light to shine on it. It might be fun for playing little games where you send notes back and forth and you both have a black light and you can see secret notes, but if you have any idea on how one might use a blacklight ink, let me know. I'd like to do more with it because it was fun, but I have no idea what to use it for. So it might be the most useless art supply that I own. Even if it was really fun and I might do it again sometime, it does not seem particularly helpful. So there you go. Supplies are listed in the doobly-doo if you have an idea and you want to try it out yourself. There's also blacklight markers that I'll link down there if you want to try colored blacklight markers. They look like they could be fun too. I might pick some up. And I will see you again in another video coming up soon.